पार्लियामेंट्री डिक्टेशन एट द स्पीड ऑफ 80 वर्ड्स पर मिनट फ्रॉम शेखर शॉर्ट हैंड मैगजीन लास्ट 5 सेकेंड्स रेडी बी रेडी स्टार्ट। मिस्टर प्रेसिडेंट परमिट मी सर टू इनवाइट योर अटेंशन टू एन इंसिडेंट विच टुक प्लेस ऑन द हिस्टोरिक Midsummer night of August 1415. I must apologize to you, sir, and to the house for harking back on the old times, but in view of intrinsic importance of the matter, I will request you to condone the delay in bringing it to your notice. You will be pleased to recollect, sir, that on the night of the assumption of power ceremony, the first item of the agenda was the singing of the Vande Mataram. Some of us in this house noticed that a number of our honorable friends entered the assembly chamber. I would almost say trooped into this hall. After the song had been sung, I would request you, sir, to look into this matter because there are certain considerations which arise from this action of theirs. They entered the hall simultaneously, so simultaneously that it gave the appearance of the act having been performed not so much by accident as by design. You will be pleased to remember that the assembly had resolved to leave this matter of program entirely in your hands, and they were in duty bound as members of this house to participate in the program. My friends all very well know that this song, though it has not been adopted by this house as our national anthem yet, it is a song, sir, which has been consecrated, sanctified by the suffering and sacrifice, blood and tears, and the martyrdom of thousands of our countrymen and women. I shall be happy to hear from those members who came after the national song had been sung that they did so not by design but only by accident. Thank you. Mr. President, I am really pained to see this matter being raised by an honorable friend of mine for whom I have great respect and love. As a matter of fact, sir, most of us did feel that the behavior of some of our colleagues in this house was not quite in the fitness of things. Yet we here cannot force anybody. May I rise to point of order, sir? I do not know what we are talking about. I have found on many occasions some members stand up without any motion before the house You have been so good, sir, as to permit that kind of thing. But I do not know if it is proper for a member to stand up and talk without being called by you. There must be a definite motion before the house on which we can talk. Therefore, I think it is a most improper procedure for some members to stand up without any motion before the house, and therefore I want your ruling on this. I think the matter should now be closed. We have heard from Mr. Kamath what he had to say. We have also heard something from Mr. Balakrishna Sharma. I do not know what can be done by pursuing the matter further. I think we had better drop it there. We shall take up now the items. The next item is item number 27. Stop.